Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to Arlington Street Church, gathered in love and service for justice and peace. Welcome to the Soul of Sunday. We are Unitarian Universalists. Ours is a historic faith with a progressive theology. We affirm the worth and dignity of every being, and that we are all deeply interconnected. We are bound to one another not by creed, but by covenant. And we are called to answer the call of love with open minds, open hearts, and open hands. Whoever you are, those of all nations, all creeds, all colors, all kinds of love, you are welcome here. As we gather, we acknowledge that Arlington Street Church occupies the ancestral homeland of the Massachusetts. By making this land acknowledgement, we recognize, honor, and affirm the sovereignty of all First Nations peoples. Would our veterans please rise as you're able or give us a wave so we may recognize you. Georgie, stand up. We want to honor you. In 1918, at the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, the fighting officially ended. In a railroad car in the forests of Compiègne, France, Germany signed an armistice agreement with the Allies, marking the formal ending of World War I. On this Veterans Day Sunday, I invite you to join me now in a moment of silence as a sign of respect both for the 37 million people who died in that war, for all those who have lost their lives in conflict since then, and for their loved ones. In the United Kingdom, it is traditional to read the close of Lawrence Binyon's For the Fallen, and for you to join me in repeating the fourth and final line, which says, "We will remember them." Let's do that now. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. In honor of our veterans, let us rededicate ourselves to the peace of which all veterans dream. Amen.
Comes a pitter patter, and I'd like to be safe bed. Skies are weeping while the world is sleeping, trouble heaping on our head. It is vain to remain and chatter and to wait for a clearer sky. Helter-skelter, I must fly for shelter till the clouds roll by. A pitter-patter, and I'd like to be safe in bed. Skies are weeping while the world is sleeping, trouble heaping on our head. It is vain to remain and chatter and to wait for a clearer sky. Helter-skelter, I must fly for shelter till the clouds roll by. Helter-skelter, I must fly shelter till the clouds roll by.
Thank you.
Thank you, Joe. Dear ones, welcome. Welcome to our Zoomers. Welcome to the congregation gathered in person. I want to say a very special welcome to our beloved George Ledger, visiting from the Only a Child Mission in Guatemala City, of which he is the founder. George, can you just stand up so we can love you? We are so happy you're here. Welcome, sweetheart. Beautiful. I hear that New Jersey's in the house. Is it true? Yes, they are. All right, this is two coming-of-age groups. Where's Summit? Summit's over there, fabulous. And Montclair must be over here. Friends, we're so glad you're here. Welcome. Welcome to Coming of Age. Great to see you. Well, thank you to today's volunteers. Thanks to the greeters and ushers, to our tech team, the worship team, musicians, the Arlington Street Church Choir. It's a big day in the Arlington Street Church Choir. They're doing a doubleheader today. Friends, thank you so much. All directed by Mark David Buckles. Thank you, sweetheart. It's great. Reverend Beth is here in the sanctuary and also in the Zoom room. Hi, darling. Great to see you. This afternoon at 2 o'clock here in the sanctuary, both in person and on Zoom, we will be memorializing longtime Arlington Street member Jean Monahan. There will be no fewer than 4 Arlington Street ministers in the pulpit this afternoon. I want to thank all of you who have worked so hard with Mark, David, and me to create a beautiful service to celebrate Gene's life and for the truly spectacular reception that will follow. Coming of age groups, if you're hungry, you should stay. I just want to say I feel very proud of what we've created. I know it will be of great comfort to Gene's extended family who have all come to Boston from the very deep South. We're going to show them how it's done up here. And I also just want to say to our beloved Betsy Scheer, we extend our deepest sympathy as we memorialize your best friend today. Betsy's going to speak, and it is going to be amazing. Beautiful. Friends, the sanctuary is mask optional. Please find your comfort level. Masks are available from the ushers. For those of you who are new to Arlington Street, a very special welcome to you. If you're here in person, there are welcome cards in the pew racks. You could hand yours to an usher or drop it in the basket at the great doors as you leave. For those of you in the Zoom room, please fill out a connection card. The link is in the chat. It includes the option to request the link to a recording of today's sermon. Since we can't greet all of you in person after the service, Reverend Beth and I would love to follow up with a virtual hello. Whether you have been coming here for years or today is your very first time at Arlington Street, welcome home.
Good morning.
Morning, Pat.
If you're here in person, there are printed copies of the order of service available from the ushers back at the great doors. If you're zooming in, the order of service will appear in the chat, or you can download it on our homepage at ascboston.org. Also on the homepage, you'll find a link to Sermon Bingo. Feel free to play along while Reverend Kim preaches. As we begin our greetings, I invite the Zoomers and those in person with a device handy to please say hello in the chat. Tell us where you're zooming in from today. And now, ace cinematographer Richard Brew is going to turn the camera on our in-person congregation as we wave with each other at our friends in the Zoom room, and you all in the Zoom room can wave and smile back. Hello, friends. Let's all engage that Arlington Street spirit of welcome that transcends physical distance as we greet one another heart to heart.
Our first hymn this morning is Better Days by Emma's Revolution, Pat Humphreys, and Sandy O. They actually wrote this song to be used as a hymn at a UU church, and we're doing that now. So all the words are printed in the order of service and are available in the chat. I'm going to just teach you a little bit. So first of all, the verses each have a refrain that's just 3 words. So, like in verse 1, the refrain is in the light, and the just melody goes, in the light, at the end of every line. So you could sing all the words with me, but I'll sing like, we have come in the light to this place, in the light. So let's just try that real quick. I'll sing, we have come in the light to this place, in the light. Great, and that continues. And then I'm going to choose the chorus as well. It goes like this. It starts, let us sing for today. Let us sing for today. Let us learn better ways. Let's try that. Let us sing. Let us sing for today. Let us learn better ways. And then it continues with the kind of call and response thing, which again, you could do either part of. It goes like this. Showing love in the light, giving hope in the light, we create in the light better days. And those words, in the light, change to in the dark for verse 2, and we begin in verse 3. It's a really beautiful, I think, a set of lyrics that just includes the light and the dark and the positive and the negative and all the places that we find ourselves on any given day. I invite us to rise in body, rise in spirit, and let's sing together Better Days by Emma's Revolution. We have come to this place with our hearts open wide. We are here giving voice to the truth. Showing.
It is now time for our treasured ritual of sharing community candles of sorrow and joy. These candles were submitted on our website by the Friday evening deadline. If you didn't submit your candle and have a joy or a sorrow to share this morning, please wait until the third candle is lit, the silent candle, and then type your joy or sorrow into the chat. Zoomers are invited to light silent candles at home. Those in the sanctuary are invited to light a silent candle at the table up front to the right of the Gleason podium. In addition to sharing our joys and sorrows this morning, let's reach out to one another in the week ahead, staying connected. May these times remind us of how very precious our beloved community is. We need one another. Whether together or apart, may we stay very close. And now, in the spirit of invocation, let's join in singing Sanctuary. The words are printed in your order of service and in the chat.
Today with heavy hearts, we open our hearts to you.
A candle of sorrow from Lois Hartsoff. I learned that six of my colleagues and friends on my team at my former job were all laid off this week. May they quickly find new jobs. Our final candle is an ongoing candle of sorrow from the ASC community for the people of Israel and Gaza. For all those who suffer and all those who mourn.
Come today in joy. We share your joy.
A mixed candle from the Arlington Street Church congregation in celebration of the life of Jean Monahan. Jean was a longtime member of the ASC choir and would have loved today's music. Our final candle of joy is from Queen Cheryl. My old cat Alice has been diagnosed with feline dementia. One of the symptoms is that the cat undergoes a complete personality change. For her entire life, Alice has been aloof and standoffish, a true Grisabella. My girl has indeed gone through a personality change, but I'm grateful at the very end of her life, she snuggles with me in bed and wants to be petted. The real reason for this candle of joy is that this week, for the very first time in her life, Alice played with me, both a miracle and a gift. Mama loves her big girl.
Thank you.
all the joys we hold in our hearts, we light a silent candle to remember and to rejoice. May the peace of this sanctuary enter into our hearts as we share a quiet moment together, breathing our prayers for ourselves, for one another, and for the world. Amen.
Let's join now in saying together the affirmation and covenant of our beloved spiritual community. The words are printed in your order of service and in the chat. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and service is our gift. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to speak our truths in love, and to help one another. El amor es el espíritu de nuestra congregación. El servicio es nuestro regalo. Esto es a lo que nos comprometemos. Convivir en paz, hablar nuestras verdades con amor y ayudarnos los unos a los otros. Our second hymn today is hymn number 1015 in the Teal hymnals, I Know I Can Go On. Please rise as you are willing and able. Join in singing here or wherever you are. 1015, I Know I Can Go On.
And burdens weigh
Years ago, our intern minister, Rebecca Froom, now serving our congregation in Quincy, Massachusetts, was reflecting on the holiday season that had just passed. Well, she said, like from Halloween on, it was all Christmas. I subscribe to this idea. It may well be a fantasy that forewarned is forearmed, that maybe, just maybe, we could do something about this so we don't wake up on New Year's Day feeling hungover from too much, and too little that is nourishing and restorative. Over the years, in what should be the most wonderful time of the year, I have heard people complain about the hectic pace, stress, commercialization, overwhelm, obligation, overspending, overindulgence, disappointment, and sadness. And overlaid on all of that, the holidays naturally lend themselves to nostalgia. Our sense of loss and grief is heightened as memories threaten to flood and taint every celebration. This morning's sermon is my white paper on surviving and thriving through the holidays. My hope is that you will add to it so it's something that can become truly useful to us and to whomever we might have the opportunity to help. I invite you to pull up just one moment from a holiday, any holiday that brings joy in the remembering. Just go with your first thought. That feeling is what we're after. Let's start by deconstructing the added stress of these times. There's the stress to buy, which can so often lead to the misery of overspending, the stress to be many things to many people, or the stress of wondering where you'll be at all, the stress to be happy. These are all external pressures, meaning it's important to remember that we have some choice about which ones we're willing to entertain. And then it's time to fire up some stress reduction techniques. The baseline is to start with our physical well-being, eating and drinking healthily and sleeping deeply, making sure we play as well as work. I also love the directive to learn to relax at will. When our youngest daughters were in elementary school, Mrs. Knoyer might be in the middle of teaching a math class when she would call out, "Deer," which meant not that there was a deer, but drop everything and read. The kids would instantly grab a book and find a cozy place to curl up and read, and the usually lively room would get very quiet. And then after a quarter of an hour or so, Mrs. C would gently invite them back to their regular schedule. The change in the energy in the room was palpable. The pause had refreshed. So I'm going to suggest that we just call out, "Dear," to ourselves and to one another, even if someone doesn't know what it means. It's like an endearment, right? "Dear," and everything will go better. Alternatives to a few minutes of reading are stretching or meditation, petting your resident four-footed, listening to a beautiful piece of music, getting outside, or just breathing. You know what restores you. Even 5 minutes can clear your mind and give you back your perspective, flexibility, common sense, and your sense of humor. Health Journey's Bella Ruth Napersteck writes, "This is especially important around holiday time, when trying too hard to do much creates the exact opposite of the festive feeling you're striving for, and you morph into the cranky, resentful, martyred, overworked Scrooge that you really don't aspire to be." Be realistic and know your limits. It's a wonderful thing to know what you can and cannot do. Wrestle your perfectionism to the ground and don't let idealized expectations press you into doing more than you can realistically manage. Set boundaries. Say no. Work smart. So that's stress. Now let's consider overindulgence, which is absolutely baked into celebrating. If we were talking about just one night, it might be different, but we are talking about the triple crown of overeating. Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, throw in Hanukkah, you have a quadruple crown. And then there's the crown jewel of excessive drinking, New Year's Eve. Really, an important chapter in the holiday survival guide should be strategizing how not to self-destruct while we celebrate. When our kids were little, a friend taught me not to send them to birthday parties hungry. She would stuff her boys with nourishing food so they wouldn't have room to gorge on cake and ice cream and stagger home on a sugar high only to crash. We can try this on ourselves before we head out to holiday parties. And if you live for, say, eggnog or latkes, and your idea of holiday joy is to indulge in as much or as many as you can in this short season, maybe, just maybe, whatever our favorite holiday indulgences are, we could be a little bit strategic about them and spread them out. There are certain kinds of candy available only during the holiday season. I know this because Kem buys many, many, many bags of them. Actually, they live in our freezer all year long, and she happily thaws just a little bit at a time. I have it on good authority that frosted Christmas cookies and Kugel are still delicious, having been frozen and thawed. Next up is managing outsized expectations. In this candy shop of a season, the temptation to overcommit is a siren song. Ask yourself, what is realistic for me? Really? If your role model is Martha Stewart, please keep in mind she has a staff. She has a very large staff to help her shop and decorate. Santa is not the only one who should be making a list. Best to bear down and try to manage our time. There have been days when there was so much to do, I was afraid to make a list. The thought of seeing it all in all its giantness was completely overwhelming. But if you can bring yourself to do it, take a good hard look, see what's humanly reasonable, and if you have to bow out with apologies, bow out. One of the best things we can do to survive the holidays is to make room. Notably, a very big theme on Christmas Eve. Try not to run from store to store or party to party. Leave time to catch your breath, reflect, look ahead, acquaint yourself with that calmer class of neurohormones that return you to equilibrium. Especially if you're grieving, give yourself time and space. There can also be room for joy. I told the good people at Beth's and my weekly tea party that the first time I took our kids out trick-or-treating, their only experience that bore any resemblance to that was accompanying me on parish calls. So at the first house, they ring the bell, the door opens, they duly yell, "Trick-or-treat!" And then they sped past our astonished neighbor, plopped down on his living room couch, a witch and a little mermaid waiting to visit. I tried to explain that this wasn't visiting time. To no avail. He brought them candy and they just sat there eating Reese's, holding court. Lesson: we should make time to visit rather than rushing from house to house. The holidays may come with precious memories that may also be painful. They may be fraught with difficult memories, making us want to crawl into a cave until it's all over and we're safe to come out again. Remember that comparison is the thief of joy. Neither compare this holiday season to other holiday seasons or yourself to others. It's a fruitless enterprise. Just be here now. Extended family can be the cause of great joy or a kind of grinding misery at holiday time. Psychologist Dr. James Francis writes, "The key to interacting with a difficult person or group of people is to restrict their chaos from becoming internalized by you. Do not surrender your inner peace by accepting any negative core beliefs about yourself. Have a plan for interaction with them and control what you can." I have a vivid memory of standing in our tiny kitchen with my cousin Keith on a Thanksgiving that our mothers, who are sisters, were both in rare form. Keith and I just looked at each other, took hands, and very quietly recited the third step prayer: "Take away my difficulties, that victory over them may bear witness to those I would help." Having an ally is so helpful. The two best pieces of advice I've received about interacting with people who are difficult are these. Number one, from A Course in Miracles, ask yourself, would you rather be happy or would you rather be right? If you'd rather be happy, keep weighing your options and lean into happiness. If you'd rather be right, this isn't going to work for you. But maybe best piece of advice number two will help. Just say, "Oh." No matter what they say, just say, "Oh." You can practice, "Oh, oh." It's a real showstopper. Later you can laugh about it. And to all of this, I would add, have a getaway plan. And have a recovery plan. Perhaps like some of you years ago, I instituted a feast of the leftovers on the weekend following Thanksgiving to recover from family time. I think of it as the big do-over. Even though, blessedly, my difficult family members have all gone on to their reward, we still gather with neighbors and friends to feast after the feast, and it's always wonderful. Connecting with those who truly care about you, inspire you, and support you is so nourishing. Start here. Reverend Beth, Mark David, and I are creating a guide to the holidays here. It all begins next Sunday, Thanksgiving Sunday, at Arlington Street. We'll give thanks at Thanksgiving and make a practice of gratitude all through the holiday season. With all my heart, I invite you to join in these lovely offerings with this beloved spiritual community, to join us in living into the deepest meanings and the greatest joys of this season. All are welcome. Beloved spiritual companions, in anticipation and preparation for what is to come, I'll close with these words adapted from Methodist minister Jan Richardson. All throughout these months, as the shadows have lengthened, this blessing has been gathering itself, making ready, preparing for this time. Believe me when I tell you, this blessing will reach you. Even if you have not light enough to read it, it will find you, even though you cannot see it coming. You will know the moment of its arriving by your release of the breath you have held so long, a loosening of the clenching in your hands, of the clutch around your heart, a thinning of the darkness that had drawn itself around you. This blessing does not mean to take the night away, but it knows its hidden roads, knows the resting spots along the path, knows what it means to travel in the company of friends. So when this blessing comes, take its hand, get up, set out on the road you cannot see. This is the night when you can trust that any direction you go, you will be walking toward the dawn. Come, beloveds, let us go together. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you to our soloists, Beck Zare, Megan Cook. Thank you to the rest of the choir, to Hyun Ju Jung on piano, and all under the direction of Mark David Vocals. Thank you all. Arlington Street is entirely self-sustaining. It's up to us. And it's our generosity, and our generosity continues to be astounding. Thank you for your commitment to our staff, our building, and our beloved spiritual community. Each Sunday, we share our collection plate with a partner in our mission of love, service, justice, and peace. Today, our gifts will go to Only a Child, founded in Guatemala City in 1994 by Arlington Street member George Ledger. Our gifts will support the Only a Child home and sponsor tuition at high-quality independent secondary schools and universities for youth from impoverished backgrounds. A couple of items. As a genealogist, I hold the seventh principle of Unitarian Universalism closest to my heart, the respect for the independent web of all existence of which we are a part. Also, I'm Santa. Okay, not really the Santa. Wait, there should be a spoiler alert in there someplace, no? I am the Kulibek House Santa in Kim's Kim's view of Santa is we are all Santa. So I'm the House Santa. As one of Santa's helpers, you learn to listen, pay attention to suggestions, both written and spoken, formal and informal, overt and subtle. Even the most casual of hints is noted, and I find that one's connections to others are enhanced by the simple act. In a way, staying connected is a form of generosity, and I believe the opposite is also true, that connections not only enable us to be more generous, but to also be more receptive to the generosity of others in all forms of manifestations, whatever they may be. Last Wednesday evening in the parking lot of a Whole Foods near the Mystic River in Medford, perhaps 30 or 40 Canada geese, having just taken off from the nearby water, flew directly over my head, barely clearing the nearby trees before flying off into the distance. They may have only been 50 feet away from me. I was the only person in the parking lot who stopped to regard their majesty and realized that perhaps their joyous noise as they ascended to point south was their way of drawing attention to what they could offer to us in their generosity, an awe-inspiring low-altitude cacophonous display of large flying feathered creatures happily honking away as if they were all channeling Russell Crowe's Gladiator or the post-goal celebrations of Megan Rapinoe. Are you not entertained? Honk, honk. Is this not why you are here? The least I could do was offer them my full attention and bear witness by graciously receiving this generosity. Please take a moment now to join me in giving to our beloved spiritual community and filling our virtual collection plate. You can give online by scanning the QR code in the order of service. Go to our homepage at aseboston.org, text your GIF or Venmo at Arlington Street. If you're Zooming, you can mail a check to the church. If you're in person, please use the envelopes in the pews, which can be handed to Reverend Kim, Reverend Beth, or to any of our ushers after the service. Thank you for your generosity.
There is hope in our eyes when we truly see each other, like the light of countless stars. We are not afraid of the dark, 'cause there is hope. Every single beat we feel it to the ends of the earth, our echo carries on. We are sacred, we are strong. We are are beautiful, we belong. Please hear our unheard song. Story told. We are sacred, we are strong. We are beautiful, we belong. Please hear our
Beck. Thank you, Mark David. I'm out of words. That was amazing. As Reverend Kim has mentioned earlier, we will be memorializing Gene Monahan this afternoon at 2 p.m. Please join us here in person or on Zoom. All are welcome. If you're here in person, Lisa Dropkin will be at the great doors as you leave today, taking final orders for delicious Thanksgiving pies to benefit community servings. There's also an online form on our homepage at ascboston.org. Let's order lots of pies to support this wonderful organization, which delivers hot meals to critically and chronically ill individuals and their families. Thank you, Lisa. As always, there are weekly gatherings in our Zoom room for loving kindness meditation, poetry, yoga, and writing. In addition, this Tuesday evening, Reverend Kim also hosts Buddhist Belly book group and the Arlington Street Meditation Center. On Wednesday afternoon, Professor Alan Helms and Reverend Kim host our literary salon, The Wednesdays, reading the poetry of 20th century American poet Frank O'Hara. Every Wednesday at 4 p.m., Reverend Kim and Reverend Both host a tea party with a conversation prompt. This week's prompt is, what can you count on to brighten your day? Tell us one thing you'll do to brighten a day this week. And back in person, for those of you in the Boston area who love to sing, come join the choir. Mark David holds rehearsals here at the church on Thursday evenings at 7 p.m. and no experience is necessary. Next Sunday, November 19th, is Thanksgiving Sunday here at Arlington Street. Our choir will perform Song of the Universal by Norwegian composer Ola Yeo. The 12-minute cantata is scored for eight-part choir, string orchestra, and piano. The Song of the Universal is a setting of Walt Whitman's poem of the same name, in which he expresses unabashed optimism, exuberance, and an unwavering confidence in our deeper humanity. This would be an especially great Sunday to bring family and friends to share in the magic. Whenever there's a string orchestra here, it's not to be missed. Information and Zoom room links are at ascboston.org. To attend any of them, you don't have to be a member. You don't have to turn on your video or talk if you don't want to, and they're all free. All are always welcome. Following the service, everyone is welcome to join the virtual coffee hour. If you'd like to participate, please answer yes to the breakout room invitation that will appear on your screen. After the service, Reverend Kim and Reverend Beth will be at the end of the center aisle. If you're here in person, let's greet each other after virtual coffee hour. Thanks to all of you who joined in today's service and to all those who made it possible. Remember, we're all in this together, and I love you all.
Thanks, Patrick. Our final hymn is Lean On Me by Bill Withers. The words are available in your order of service and in the chat. They're also available in the Teal Hymnal, I believe, 1021. And I'll kind of call out the lyrics as we go a little bit too. It's always fun to sing without music if you think you might be able to. I invite us to rise in body, rise in spirit, and let's sing Bill Withers' lasting anthem, Lean On Me. Here we go, sometimes
in our lives we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong and I'll be your friend, I'll help you on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean. Please swallow your pride, please swallow your pride. If there are things you need to borrow for, no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let. Lean on me. Somebody to
benediction, I invite those of you in the Zoom room to please reach out your hands and touch the sides of your Hollywood Square. And those of you in the sanctuary to please raise your hands, palms out. Let's send loving kindness to the people to your left and to your right. Send loving kindness to the person on either side of you and to the people on either side of them. Send out love into this beloved spiritual community and feel it coming back to you. Love is the spirit of this congregation. And now for our benediction, I invite you to put your hands over your heart and namaste. I honor the divine in you. When this blessing comes, take its hand, get up. Set out on the road you cannot see. This is the night when you can trust that any direction you go, you will be walking toward the dawn. Let us keep this faith, beloveds, and pass it on. The service begins when the service ends. Bless your hearts. I love you. Amen.
Thank you. please visit ascboston.org for more information about this historic Unitarian Universalist congregation. Arlington Street Church, gathered in love and service for justice and peace.